Hello and welcome to the third part of my video series on building a diesel heater for the animal house. In the first two videos, I introduced you to the new VEVOR diesel heater, and I showed you how I installed the Chinese heater into the heating box. In this video, I want to show you how I install the electrical system and then attach the entire heating box to the outside of the garden house. I'll show you how I install the warm air duct and reconnect the circulation from the house back to the heating box. If you want to know how I do it and whether the diesel heater works in the end, then stay tuned. We're about to get started. The photovoltaic off-grid system is simply not powerful enough to supply the animal house with enough electricity for the electric fan heater during winter. The batteries just didn't last long enough. That's why I decided to build a heating box. For this, I installed a diesel parking heater, a Chinese heater from VEVOR. In the last videos, I showed you how I set up the connections for the warm air, the combustion air, the exhaust, and the circulation into the heating box. I also installed the transformer that provides the 12 volt power supply. At the moment, the power cable is only temporarily connected to a regular 220 volt cable. The 220 volt cable has a Schuko plug on the other end. Later, this is supposed to be connected to the battery, connected to my PV system. This way, the heater remains largely self-sufficient, apart from the diesel. The heater is also no longer as vulnerable during the darker months of the year. Today, I want to start perfecting these passages. I really don't like the hole with the cable. That's why I'm going to install this waterproof connector. On one side, the connector will be permanently mounted to the box, and on the other side, the cable will have a mobile plug. I can then plug in or unplug the connector at any time. This way, the mobile heating box can also be used for other purposes, for example, for camping or caravanning. I simply take the heating box with me and use it for a rooftop tent or the camper van. There it heats independently. Besides installing the connector for the power supply, I also want to install the remote control, which is currently still located at the front of the diesel heater, into the animal house. The remote control has a temperature control, and I can set the temperature in the birdhouse to an accuracy of 1 degree Celsius. The parking heater then regulates itself automatically. For this, I have to cut the cable and create a passage through the box into the garden house. There, I will permanently install the remote control and reconnect it. Then I can control the heater from inside. Additionally, I also have to build the duct connection for the ventilation, of course. Somehow the heated air has to get into the house. Here you can see the empty conduits that are meant to protect the cables. This is the air outlet. It ensures that the air is properly distributed inside the house. Here are a whole bunch of other things I need for this project. The animal house has an outdoor aviary, and inside I have an area of about 9-10 square meters of floor space that I need to heat. I won't be installing the heating box inside because the diesel heater is too loud for me. There's also the risk that the smell of diesel could get into the house, and that's too big of a risk for me. That's why I'm going to mount the mobile heating box on the back of the house. I'll screw the parking heater to the back in such a way that I can access it at any time. I'll also secure the aluminum box against theft. I've already set up a power supply. The socket gets its power directly from the inside. Inside, nothing from the heater should be visible in the animal house. The birds have their area in the upper part of the house, while the rodents live on the floor. The electric fan heater that I'm currently using has an integrated thermostat and is also controlled by this manual thermostat at the socket. This also works after a power outage. I have installed an additional switch here to turn the outdoor socket on and off. My goal is to remove these devices from the animal house and instead install two ventilation inlets, one on the left and one on the right. On one side, warm air should be blown into the house, and on the other side, the room air should be sucked out again. There, the air is directed into the heater and reheated. I deliberately decided not to draw in cold, fresh air. At these freezing temperatures below zero, would have to be completely reheated to the desired temperature. Through the circulation, the air has a higher supply temperature, and I can save quite a bit on heating costs. The heating box is mounted on the back of the house. The box is installed in such a way that the lid can be opened easily. The gap is large enough so that the lid stays open on its own. The box is initially screwed on provisionally. I will later secure the construction further with special screws to prevent theft. On the underside, you can see the construction. The bracket, the crossbar, and the longitudinal bar. I have decoupled them with rubber washers. This way, the vibrations from the diesel engine cannot be transmitted into the house. I will now connect the hose, attach the air hose. The angle should be as small as possible to go directly into the house. The same thing is done again on the other side. That's where the warm air comes out and is then blown in here. A hole will be drilled here, and on the inside, the ventilation grill will be mounted. On the other side, the ventilation duct will again lead outside. Led and plugged into the heating box, then the VEVOR diesel heater already works in circulation mode. For now, I'll just reconnect the electrical wiring provisionally, and then the animals will already have a warm home tonight. Before I continue with the installation, let's take a short break here with a request for you. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up now. I would be absolutely thrilled about that. If you haven't done so yet, click the subscribe button in the bottom right corner. Then you won't miss any of my new videos. Also, please check the description below the video. There you'll find all the materials I used to build my diesel heating box. Write me a comment and give me some feedback on what you think about this project. I reply to everyone, you know that. But enough talk, let's continue with the installation of the ventilation pipes. I've installed the connections for the power supply and the remote control inside the box. These plug contacts are fastened to the box with three screws. On the inside, I also secured the plugs with nuts. I have meticulously connected all the necessary cables within three distinct junction boxes. The primary cable, originating directly from the main power supply, diligently runs into this particular box and is then securely connected to the essential transformer utilizing reliable WAGO connectors. From this crucial transformer, the electrical cable subsequently continues its path, now carrying a safe and consistent 12 volts directly into the heater unit. In the third and final box, which is conveniently located further back here, only the specific cable intended for the remote control system is currently plugged in and operational. I still have the counterpart here. The remote control was attached with double-sided tape to the front. I cut it off with a utility knife and originally wanted to stick the remote control onto the lid of another junction box using silicone. That way I can connect the cables directly underneath the remote control, but I have to say, I'm actually quite pleasantly surprised by this. There are these really interesting holes on the back to hang the remote control directly on the wall with screws. That makes the installation much more elegant for me, of course. The connector is still closed at the moment. Here I will cut the cable and make the connection to the new cable inside the junction box. I installed the cable duct on the back of the house and packed both cables inside it. The power supply and the control cable are firmly connected to the box. And on the inside, I secured the cables with cable ties. Everything has to be tidy. The space inside the heating box is large enough to place a car battery here and an additional tank, because with these 5 liters, I might only get by for 2 to 3 days. I want to install a tank from boat building that is a bit larger and can hold up to 20 liters. Inside the birdhouse, it is now pleasantly warm. The control of the parking heater can be operated from inside. I removed the display from the heater and attached it to this junction box. The display is secure and the birds are already using it as a sleeping spot. With the control module, I can set the temperature individually and adjust it to my desired level. If I don't want to go into the house, of course, I can also use the remote control for that. A click on the plus button and I can increase the temperature. The remote control has a range of about 10 to 20 meters. For me, that's completely sufficient. I installed the air outlets below the shelf for the birds. The intake, which draws air from the house into the heating box, draws it in and heats it further. The warm air is then blown into the house from this side. My mobile heating box with the VEVOR diesel parking heater has now been running constantly for a week. The temperatures, especially at night, have dropped again to about minus 10 degrees Celsius to minus 11 degrees Celsius. With the second heating level of the 8 kilowatt diesel heater, I was able to keep the temperature in here stable at about plus 10 degrees Celsius to plus 11 degrees Celsius. The consumption has settled at around 0.2 to 0.3 liters of diesel per hour. In the future, I will run the system on heating oil. That will further reduce the costs. I connected my mobile heating box to the birdhouse and the diesel heater has been doing its job reliably. The consumption remains within limits and I can start thinking about how to further decouple the housing. The clicking of the pump is definitely audible inside. I'll show you that in another video. What else are you interested in? What should I show you in another video about the heating box? Just give me some feedback and write to me below in the comments section about what you're interested in and what else you'd like to see. If you liked my video, then give me a thumbs up. That helps me and my channel to move forward. What also helps me is if you use my product links for your own build. Just take a look at the video description below the video. There I've listed the parking heater, the box, and all the other components I used, all linked for you. Just click and buy directly. Same price for you and a small commission for me and my channel. I'm done for today. My three videos on building the diesel heater for the birdhouse in the garden are finished. If you want to see more, leave me a comment. Take care and see you at the next project. Bye.